Students, in my last lectures, I have told you what is order of a reaction, what is rate law, what is rate expression, and we have used differential equations to express the rate law. What I am trying to say that if R is my reactant, P is my product, then we define that the rate can be expressed in this form, minus dr by dt is equal to some constant n r power n, where n is the order of the reaction. This is called the differential form of the rate of the reaction. And from here we were trying to find the rates of the reactions and orders of the reaction by graphic method. These methods are not very accurate and are difficult. Therefore, an integrated rate equation method has been given. This is more mathematical. This involves integration. So, the integration involved is of very lower level, not very high level, which we will do here. Integrated rate equation, and I will be driving the integrated rate equation for zero order reaction. So, what I am going to derive for zero order reaction? Integrated rate equation. What I am interested in, integrated rate equation. If the order of this reaction is 0, then n is equal to 0. What it means, I can write this equation in this form, minus dr by dt is equal to k r power 0 or is equal to k. R power 0 will be 1. So the equation becomes minus dr by dt is equal to k for a zero order reaction, or I can write it like this, minus dr is equal to k dt, or if I take negative sign on this side. So here, now supposing the reaction r to p, I am saying the concentration of this at time t equal to 0, is r0. r0 is the concentration of r reactant at time t equal to 0. And supposing RT is the amount of R left at time T. After time T, supposing the amount of R, R0 is my concentration when at zero time. After some time, I am saying time T, 10 seconds, 20, 30, 50 or minutes, the concentration of the R which is left is RT. Or in other words, if I would say that A was the original concentration, I am saying A is the original concentration of R, and if X goes, then A minus X is the amount of R left after time T. So this will become, if this was A and if X, then X will be the amount of the product which will be formed. X is the amount of P after time T. That's what I am trying to say. So in another words, this is the concentration after time T for this R reactant, I am saying, because students do mistake here. That's what, why I have tried to explain this. So if X is used up, then the amount left is A minus X here. Now what is the story here? I want to integrate this dr by minus kdt. I want to find the value of this from time 0 to time t. Here I am integrating this from time 0 to t. So that means I am integrating this from time 0 to t. 0 to t means the concentration of r at time t equal to 0. Here I am saying the concentration which is r0, and the concentration of r at time t which is rt. So this is a small integration which we do a lot in maths. We already know that dx, if I integrate between limits x1 and x2, student, is what? x1, which is equal to x2 minus x1. This is an integration which we have learned in our 6th or 7th class also, and I am using that. So when I will integrate this, I will get r, and what will be the limits of this? आर थ्री आर जीरो कंसेंट्रेशन एट टाइम टी इक्वल टू जीरो ऑफ आर एंड कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ आर एट टाइम टी एंड इज इक्वल टू माइनस के इज कॉन्स्टेंट डी टी डी टी द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी टी विल बी व्हाट टी टी सो व्हाट आर द लिमिट्स ऑफ दिस जीरो टू टी सो व्हाट इट बिकम्स देन दिस बिकम्स आर टी माइनस आर जीरो is equal to minus kt because t zero will be zero. So this becomes an equation. This becomes an equation for the zero order reaction. Rt is the concentration of r at time t and r zero is the concentration time t equal to zero. K is my rate constant and this if I want to find the value of k, so I can say that kt is equal to we can say r zero माइनस आर टी और के विल बी इक्वल टू आर जीरो माइनस आर टी बाई टी. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द रेट कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर ए जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. नाउ लेट अस सी सम ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट द जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. जीरो ऑर्डर व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग इज द रेट इक्वेशन विच वी हैव डिफाइंड फॉर जीरो ऑर्डर. व्हाट इज अवर फॉर्मूला. आर टी is minus r zero is equal to minus k t. So this is our formula for the zero order reaction. So that means I can write it as rt is equal to what is this minus k t plus r zero minus k t plus r zero. This is nothing but the equation of a straight line y is equal to mx plus b. This is the equation of a straight line. So if a graph is made, graphs are always important. We should make graph is made between the concentration of R. Graph I am making concentration of R versus T here. So what I will get students, as you can say, this is my slope. The slope is negative. So at time when time T is zero, RT is equal to R zero, which is the original concentration. So there is some concentration at time t equal to zero, and after as the time will proceed 10, 20, 30, 40 or seconds or minutes, whatever we will use, what will happen, this will keep on decreasing. So I will get a straight line. This is a graph of a straight line, and the slope of this you already know. The slope of this is minus k. And you will see that if I extrapolate this, this will meet at this point. That means this reaction shows that there will be a time when the entire reactant will be used up. That means nothing is left according to this graph which we have. So if this is a characteristic of a zero order reaction. The graph is a straight line but with a negative slope. Slope is minus k, and there will be a time after which nothing of this R will be left. A 100% reaction will take place at this time. Important. Another graph which I can make here is, as I have said, for the zero order, the rate is equal to k r power zero. So rate is nothing but constant, and rate does not depend on the concentration of R. The rate is not depending on the concentration of the R. So if I will make a graph. If we make a graph now of the rate versus concentration for zero order, it will be like this. There is no change. As the concentration changes, the rate remains constant. The rate does not depend on the concentration for a zero order reaction. And when I plot concentration versus time, you will get a straight line with a negative slope. So this is important. Now let us see what other thing we can calculate. What is the half life of zero order reaction? What is half life? The time required for concentration of R to reduce to reduced to 1/2. If R0 was the original concentration reduced to half, that means it should become R0 by 2. If R0 is the concentration, then it should become R0 by 2. R0 by 2. That's what I'm saying. So the concentration becomes half of the original concentration. That time is called the half-life. So according to this equation, what I can say, my equation is RT. What is this? RT minus R0 is equal to minus KT. So what will happen when the concentration is, when RT becomes equal to R0 by 2, that time is called half-life. So R0 by 2 minus R0 is equal to minus KT half. Or if I change that negative sign, what you will get here, R0 by 2 is equal to KT half. Or I am saying T half is equal to R0 by 2K. Very important formula, which shows that the half-life of this zero order is proportional to the original concentration. What we are saying? Half-life is proportional to R0, which is the concentration of R. So the half-life of a zero order reaction depends on the concentration, is proportional to the concentration, is proportional to the concentration, which I have shown. Or in other words, if I make a graph of half-life versus the concentration, what is there? When the concentration is zero, half-life is zero. As the concentration increases, this value increases. So it is a straight line graph. Concentration, I have concentration of R. So what is this slope? The slope of this will be, according to this equation, slope is 1 by 2k. So here this is our slope, 1 by 2k. So we can get the value of k from this slope. This is a graph of the half-life versus concentration for a zero-order reaction. There is another life which is called the 100 full life. What do you mean by full life? Time required for 100% of R to react. 100% of R to react. That means what I am saying, R goes to P, that time when 100% of this reacts. When 100% reacts, then what happens? Then the concentration at RT will become equal to 0. That means all the reactant has been converted into product. All the reactant has been converted into product. So what will this equation? That means RT minus R0 is equal to minus KT. If I say 100%, then this will become 0. Therefore, I can say minus R0 is equal to minus KT 100, or 100% means, so if 100% reaction takes place, we can say this will be equal to minus plus R0 by K. So this is the time required for the reaction to complete, or 100% completion. There are two formulas. As you can say, this half-life is half of this value, because this is a zero order reaction, and the characteristic of zero order is very clear, that this will finish after a definite period of time according to the integrated rate law which we have given. What is the use of this? Let me give you, I have two questions which I am going to solve for it. Question one, it says that ammonia, decomposition of ammonia to form nitrogen gas plus 3 hydrogen gas is a zero order reaction, and you are given the value of K, 3 into 10 minus 3 mole liter inverse second inverse. He says what is the rate of the reaction first. Second, he says what are the rates of production of N2 and hydrogen. So how will you do it, student? If I write the rate of this reaction, the rate is nothing. The differential rate equation you already know is minus 1 by 2 d NH3 by dt is equal to plus d N2 by dt is equal to plus 1 by 3 dH2 by dt. So what we have, since it's a zero order reaction, the rate is equal to k. Rate is equal to k for zero order. For zero order you already know. So the rate is equal to 3 into 10 minus 3, which is given here. And if you want to find the production of nitrogen, the production of nitrogen is d N2 by dt, which is equal to rate, which is 3 into 10 minus 3. And if you want to find the rate of production of hydrogen, then you know that d H2 by dt 1 by 3 is equal to rate, or if I take 3 here into 3. So 3 into 3 into 10 minus 3 mole liter inverse second inverse. So we can find the rate of production also by using this equation, this numerical which I have given. This is the solution of this. One more numerical which I want to tell you. The second question which I have is the rate constant. He says, question 2, the rate constant of zero order in R is 0.050 mole liter inverse second inverse. How long will it take for concentration of R to fall from 0.150 to 0.120 molar. So you already know the students the equation which I have given. RT is equal to minus KT plus R0. So we can apply this formula. RT is the concentration after time t. R0 is the concentration original, and this is our time t divided by k. This is minus here. So what is the value of RT, the concentration after time t? It says 0.120 minus 0.150. What is the value of k? 0.050 minus and minus plus. So minus, this is minus. So this value which you are getting is how much? Minus and minus will become plus. So plus 0.3 divided by 0.050. So we can get the value of the time in seconds. This is the value of the time which we are getting in seconds from this. 0.150 minus 0.120030. So 0.03 divided by 0.05. This is the time which is coming in seconds for such a reaction. We can find the values, students. And what you got here is the time for a particular reaction. Okay, I will meet you in my next class for further first order reaction.